Hi, I'm Natalia Munoz, the news director for Holyoke Media. We're speaking with Mayor Morse today on the Barr Foundation rescinding $275,000 to the city of Holyoke to research and plan for energy resources, how in the future, what should Holyoke do. Some of the city councilors made comments about HG&E not being part of this process. We at Holyoke Media reached out to the HG&E, and we received this response from Kate Sullivan, who is the spokeswoman. She said, the Barr Foundation grant was requested by the city of Holyoke, not HG&E. With that said, HG&E does not oppose the grant and would collaborate with the city on any elements of the plan that align with our goals and objectives. This is a comment she made way back in May 18. And yet city councilors this week, mayor, again referred to HG&E is not part of the process and they didn't know where HG&E stood. How did this gift from the Barr Foundation get lost?
This is just completely embarrassing in so many ways. And I am embarrassed on behalf of the city council. And I mean, the climate crisis is upon us. There is a natural gas moratorium in the city of Holyoke and surrounding communities. And some counselors in that body use this grant as an opportunity to make a political statement about their support for new natural gas pipeline infrastructure. What they didn't quite understand is that this grant was completely, this would actually help Holyoke support residential and commercial customers by educating residents, working hand in hand with the city and Holyoke Gas and Electric to get some of our biggest users off of natural gas to make up more space for new users. And so I am opposed to any further expansion of natural gas pipeline infrastructure. I think it's foolish to spend tens of millions of dollars to expand pipelines that will no doubt be in a shortage several years from now. And the climate crisis is here. It's time we get off of fossil fuels and make those investments in renewable energy products. And so this grant actually provided money to the city to envision a fossil fuel-free future in Holyoke and to set a precedent for other communities like it. How do you support economic development and our residents, residential construction, while at the same time having natural gas restraints? That was the fundamental question of this. And unfortunately, we see counselors using these lame excuses as to why to oppose this particular grant. And I mean, even just the undertones, not even undertones, but the overtures of racism targeted at neighbor to neighbor and their involvement in this organization. When you run for office, when you're part of public service, whether you're with the city or gas and electric, you set yourself up to be held accountable by the people that put you there in the first place. And the fact that we have a few counselors that are somehow offended that activists and organizers and residents, you know, showed up to people's offices and made phone calls and sent emails advocating for something that they believe in, the fact that they're so offended by that they are still using it as an excuse to oppose a grant is just completely unacceptable and discouraging and just quite disgusting, honestly. And this is a vote against Holyoke. It's a vote against our best interests. And, you know, a counselor can support a gas pipeline while also supporting larger efforts around how to get the city off of fossil fuels and make sure we do it in a just way. And so I was incredibly disappointed by the conversation, by the tone. I will say about gas and electric, you know, they were very clear about not being opposed to the grant, but they had every reason to support this. And for some reason, leadership there still refused to come out very strongly and say, yeah, the gas and electric didn't apply for this, but the city did, and we're a willing and able partner. And some counselors were looking for that. It was disappointed to see, you know, one counselor, Counselor Peter Tallman, go from a yes vote to a no vote, specifically citing a conversation with Jim Lavelle. And so I'm very curious as to, you know, what happened in that conversation. And, you know, I'll be asking Jim Lavelle the substance of that conversation, because Peter was a consistent supporter of it. And for some reason, that conversation seems to have changed his mind. It's no secret that Gas and Electric has been pursuing this pipeline project. And, you know, and I've been very transparent about my opposition to it. But nevertheless, this is $275,000 of free money from one of the largest foundations in the state and in the country. And to burn a bridge like this, a foundation that helped us redesign our secondary education model with a $500,000 grant a few years ago, is just, I think, you know, egg on the face of the city at this point.
Also, Mayor, to be clear, Neighbor to Neighbor is a community grassroots organization. And it has two different parts. One part is a 501c, I don't know what, that can support candidates that do get money.
501c4. Yep.
Okay, thank you. And then the 501c3, that's the nonprofit part that has nothing to do with politics. And the money that the Barr Foundation gave Neighbor to Neighbor, $125,000, to do outreach on behalf of the city of Holyoke, went to that part of Neighbor to Neighbor that doesn't take a political position on people, on politics, on anything. It was really just to do neighborhood outreach work. Is that correct?
Yeah, absolutely. And we don't have the resources to dispatch dozens of organizers and volunteers to educate residents about their personal role in our city's carbon footprint. And when we met with Gas and Electric, we made it very clear, this is to add value to the city. I mean, this was a win-win-win for the city, for the Gas and Electric, for our residents. And the role of Neighbor to Neighbor was to add capacity in a way that the city and Gas and Electric didn't have capacity. And when we sat down with Gas and Electric, we said, well, do you even have a demand side management program? You know, you're saying we need this pipeline, but we don't even have programs or incentives to get our largest users, our biggest manufacturers, biggest companies to use less natural gas. And so why don't we start there before we actually build a $30 million pipeline? And then we could actually open up capacity for new residential construction units, for new businesses that people are citing. And so there's this false dichotomy between we must have a natural gas pipeline in order to promote economic development and support our residents. That's not the case. It's been proven wrong in cities all across this country. And we had an opportunity to prove that and develop this future that's possible with this money from the grant. But you are correct. Neighbor to Neighbor's role was adding capacity and community engagement that wouldn't have existed otherwise. But again, the fact that it was Neighbor to Neighbor, the fact that counselors were calling it an activist organization, the fact that people like Gas and Electric were calling it an activist organization, even in the most recent article in local media, they would not call other groups in the city activist organizations. And so I'm not sure what exactly they mean when they say activist organization. This is an organization that has been fighting for working people and working families and communities of color and low-income communities in our city. And the climate crisis affects frontline communities, communities of color, the most. And the fact that even in War II, one of the poorest, predominantly Puerto Rican neighborhood in our city is represented by someone that doesn't look like or speak the language of the people that live there, and then wants to vote against this grant that would benefit the very constituents that live there, is completely unacceptable. And it's time that we organize in War II and elect candidates that are responsive to the people that put them there in the first place.
Yes, and not that long ago, just over a year ago, there was a big conference in City Hall regarding climate change and how do cities prepare for climate change. Lieutenant Governor Karen Polito was there. You were there, the director of the Office of Planning and Economic Development was there, and other stakeholders were there. What's the next step? Is the city going to apply again next year, or do you think that the relationship with the Barr Foundation has been impacted negatively for the time being?
We've had conversation with the Barr Foundation since they rescinded the application, and we've been in touch with them throughout, and we've been very open and honest with them about the fact that, you know, the administration shares the value of the climate crisis being an existential crisis in our on our planet, and we want to do our part locally. And you know, we are ahead of our time, and I give Gas and Electric and the folks that came before me and before us a lot of credit for the infrastructure and the vision that they laid out. We have made a lot of progress. We're 92% carbon neutral on our electric grid, but we have an ambition of being 100% carbon neutral community. And to do that, we have to be innovative, and we need to invest in those things that will help us get there. And this planning process would have helped us get there with Neighbor to Neighbor as a community engagement partner. And so we do still want to accomplish the goals laid out in the grant. And so whether that means money no longer comes to the city as a governmental entity, but potentially the money can go to a different partner in the region or locally to help us achieve those goals. And so at some point, the goal has to become more important than the entity that accepts the money. And so those are the conversations that I want to have in the coming days and the coming weeks. And our council time and time again has thought that they could, you know, use their personal agendas against, again, a really important week, important work. But we're committed to this work. We're committed to these values. And where I've worked over the last 9 years, don't rest until we can accomplish what we need to accomplish and what we've been elected to accomplish.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, very much for your time today.